I'm a black man. Are you afraid of me? Are you afraid of me now?
I'm a black man. Are you afraid of me? Are you afraid of me now?
Are you afraid of me now?
The Halloween Hoodie Campaign is an anti-stereotype public service announcement rooted in this racial controversy surrounding Trayvon Martin's death. The PSA went viral in October 2012 and has since received national attention. Its creator, Rochelle Oliver, a Miami-based TV producer and filmmaker, knew she was taking a risk.
Coming up with an idea that goes against the norm is always challenging, and it's scary. You know, literally about to publish that video on YouTube, and you really didn't know what was going to happen and what people would say. The second challenge is realizing that the world is even a lot more scared to talk about race and stereotype than I even thought. But the great part about challenge is realizing that challenge shows you that there's an opportunity to make a difference.
Rochelle Oliver is a guest contributor for CNN, a contributing writer for NBC's TheGrill.com, and owns her own multi-platform production company, which has produced commercials for Hershey's, Capella University, and for ION Network, the largest broadcast station in the world. But all these achievements aside, the content of her hoodie PSA has become the groundwork for a documentary on stereotypes. WSFL-TV's David Azer asked her to explain.
So you can stop if you want to stop.
I get
stop
nervous over. A lot.
But you're Rochelle Oliver. You've been on CNN. This is nothing.
What we're doing with the documentary is explaining that, and we're looking at fear and stereotypes through a scientific perspective. We're looking at it through the brain. Which is kind of...
It's so cool, though. Like, so explain that. What are you looking for?
Well, when you speak to scientists and neuroscientists and behaviorists, what they'll tell you is that when someone is afraid of something, they will react in one or two ways. You're going to fight or flight. So we're taking this and we're examining how people would react to unfamiliar stimuli when it comes to race. So if you've never been around people with hoodies, for example, or the only exposure you've had is through the media, with someone robbing a bank or someone possibly in a dangerous situation in a music video, then you might never have had a personal experience with someone in a hoodie. So your only understanding is a fearful, to have a fearful foundation of that. And so when you see someone, you're not even reacting based off of what you see, based off of, you know, it's daylight or it's the same situation or this is a teenager.
Right. Like a preconceived notion or something, right?
You have these prejudices built up that are in your brain, and because of how fear works and how fear manifests, if you're not aware of how you react or aware of how to analyze the situation, you are going to fight or you're going to flee. And the third element there is you can freeze, but that's a minority of the groups.
What was it, freeze?
Freeze.
Yeah, just literally like freeze up.
Literally freeze up.
Yeah.
Deer in headlights.
Wow.
Well, I mean, it's great to be back in, San Sentinel, where I used to work several years ago. So it's nice to be back here. The interview, I think, went well. I'm always surprised with how interested people are with the project, especially when it is something that's so controversial. I think it always catches me a little off guard. But I think it's great. I'm not used to necessarily being in the position where people are asking me the questions. I'm more familiar with doing the asking. And so that's always kind of like a role reversal. But it's a great opportunity to be talking about the campaign.
Writer, producer, and entrepreneur. Rochelle Oliver does it all, and there's a lot more where that came from. So grab your sunglasses and watch as she reaches for the sky.